freak in the mask. What the hell are you talking about?
I was just at the security station watching the feeds. There's this creepy guy interrogating the hostage. He wears like a 3D printed mask.
Oh, yeah, that must be Berg. Oh, yeah, man, his interrogation techniques. Totally just out of box stuff. Truth serum, drugs, that kind of thing. But none of the rough stuff. You know, they don't like to mark up their patients. Those Mossad boys like things clean and efficient. Berg. Burn? Yeah. Yeah, man, I've heard of him. Chemical interrogation expert. I guess it's his makeshift lab they've set up. Where does he make it into a crack?
Aw, man, you don't know the half of it. I mean, the stuff this guy's into, get this.
Ezra Berg, legendary Mossad operative who specializes in chemical interrogation techniques, is here at the compound to interrogate a prisoner. My notes indicate he's set up a makeshift drug lab in a garage, and it looks like he's spending a lot of his time in the basement. Could be an opportunity there, 47.
Drug-induced hypnosis, memory wipes, subliminal mind
Heard something. Stand by. Command, false alarm. Nothing to report.
Bitch tells me what to do. I'll take care of them. Son of a problem.
So my standard bodyguard kit has this tear gas spray, you know? And, well, I used mine a couple of times, and they're really expensive to replace. So I started refilling it with my own blend of homemade hot sauce. So, you being a great buddy, maybe I could just try it out on your face. It'll only last a couple hours, and you'll have full vision again in the morning.
Whoa.
So what do you say? Can I spray your face?
Seriously, what is wrong with you?
Trespasser!
Sir, I've got you on my sights. You can't bash people's heads in like that. See those hands?
Hands over your head!
Something happened?
Listen,
hey, you!
Stop! Oh. Are you gonna do something?
Hey, you could get hurt sneaking around like that.
Okay, can you just leave me? Alone for a few minutes. I've got some thinking to do. I'm sure Rose won't mind.
That is Penelope Graves, acclaimed anti-terror analyst. Strange to see her as part of this crowd.
Hi, I'm Penelope Graves. Now, you look like you've been part of the crew for a while. Just, wondering how you're finding it here. Sean Rose, okay to work with?
Apart from the compulsiveness, he's all right. Pretty demanding, if you ask me, but nothing I haven't experienced before.
Okay. Anything else you can share? Anything I need to look out for?
I've heard some of the others talk about his past. Some sort of cult affiliation. I mean, I guess that explains his intensity.
Ah, your breath stinks. Greetings, sir. He's some kind of super infiltrator. Prosthetics, accents, even plastic surgery to match.
Yeah, I'm in the canteen and this guy's just eating like a pig. Sucking his fingers, making animals. What the hell is that?
Oh, those tech guys, Jesus. The other day I was firing a few rounds, one of these wimpy little kids yelled out the window telling me to keep it down. I was like ready to do some serious damage, but the boss told me to back down. It's just sad.
Yeah, I know. You know, for the first time in my life, I'm having second thoughts about this hired killer bullshit. It's like I'm almost too old for this shit.
Hands off that body!
Okay, here's a scenario. Say a perv is getting away, right? He's running the best he can. Let's say he's shot the kid or something. So would you tase him in the neck slash face or take out a leg with a shotgun?
Is that you speaking or should I get an exorcist?
Do you have demons inside that speak through you or
are you unaware of what you're saying?
Ah, yeah, so this is how we deal with things that we can't fully grasp or comprehend, huh? Yeah. Sorry, am I just, like, being too smart for you? Yeah, you need to deal with things that actually matter.
Blah, blah, blah. That's what I hear coming from you. Same old shit all the time. Funny, thinking about it, a weapon shows you who you really are. Either you press that trigger and stand up for yourself, or you don't, right?
I'm losing you, man.
What I'm saying is that a weapon is like a mirror to your soul. When it's decided who you really are, when that moment arises, it will arise precisely because you have a gun.
Oh, yeah? What about the
ulcs?
You've got the ulcs already. Seriously, man. Need a vacation. Take it easy.
Intriguing. According to Graves' ledger on Sean Rose, he is hypersensitive to the effects of drugs, in particular, hallucinogens. Last time he tried, it triggered a nasty psychotic episode, channeling his fear of germs. Interestingly, the ledger also contains a record of his most recent OCD attacks. Desk, grandfather clock, and faucet. Rose appears to smoke cigarettes when he gets agitated. What if...
Hey there. If that's obstruction, get out of here.
a little overcooked.
From a very early age, right, I understood what people want. A big, beautiful glass that brings new ears for hours, am I right? Like, for New Year's, I was always the kid with the biggest and baddest rockets on the street.
It's weird, actually. I'm sorry, soldier. You're not coming through like that. Get moving.
I have to say, it's a beautiful piece of work.
For a murderous death trap.
Well, you know, art comes in many guises. Swords can be beautiful, guns too. And this bomb, I mean, have you seen how tiny it is? Looks like a smartwatch battery. So fully integrated with the hardware that most laymen could take it apart and never even notice. Sean Rose might be an uptight, self-righteous prick, but he is a true artist.
Fine, he's an artist, but he's still a bloody coward. Bomb makers. Never liked them, never will.
Yeah, they're giving those vans a real makeover, huh? I've an idea what that's all about, but when you ask, they say it's classified. Like, you're not really part of the team, right?
Yeah, you can say that again.
It's just bad for morale. Crew must be like one big organism, you know? Well, we move together, and we fight together, and God forbid, we die together. So is it too much to ask what's going on?
Sure. I wonder what they're doing with the cars, though. How are you?
Hell of a baptism by fire, man.
You're telling me.
I'm impressed. Of course, you don't hold a candle to Maya Parvati, the training director.
Yeah, I was wondering about her. Indian?
Sri Lankan. Get this. She used to be an assassin and gunrunner for the Tamil Tigers. Her father was one of their leaders. Then, when the Tigers disbanded in 09, Parvati took work as a freelance pirate in the South China Sea for, guess who? None other than the Maelstrom.
Ah, colorful.
Yeah. And then a grenade took her arm. That was the end of it. Happened during an attack on a Hampson oil freighter.
How do you know that?
I worked security on that freighter. I fired the shell.
You did what? Jesus, does she know?
Uh-huh. When I first got here, Parvati walked right up to me. You know what she said? Good shot.
Right. Well, that settles it. I'm in love.
A little undercooked.
I've seen monkeys pack up shit faster than you're doing right now. Get a move on it.
Looking into some noises. Please hold on. Disregard. Nothing here.
Resistant fuel tank, like you said, lying bastard. You think I'd take your word for it anyway? No way. If you want something done the right way, you better do it yourself.
Oh, you were at Jordan Cross's funeral, huh?
It was a thing of beauty. Whole team moving like clockwork. Perfect. Hi, recruit. Yeah, that's unfortunately not gonna work. I can't let you through here. Bye-bye. It was a thing of beauty. Whole team moving like clockwork.
So I just found out about a training act. Tunnel Tiger.
That would be Burgess, the sharpshooter.
Those are seriously
point man people. In the Mexico operation.
I'm beginning to
you need to find another way in,
Sam, or something.
Sorry for the inconvenience.
The battering ram to
she was raised by Mercs and was allegedly one of the best assassins in all of South Asia. After the Tigers disbanded, she went off to become a pirate.
You're kidding?
No.
Anyway, the guy was lucky.
Ravaged the South China Sea with that maelstrom pirate boss who hijacked a TI class super tanker.
Is that where she lost the arm?
Crazy shit. Can you believe she lost that to a grenade fired by one of the guys here? Happened before the boss gathered us all up. Some raid on a Hampson oil freighter. It's crazy shit.
That's an awkward reunion right there, man.
This is awkward.
That is Ezra Berg, former Mossad interrogator. His services are in demand at the moment.
Oh, you're back. Great. So, listen, I've been thinking, maybe the dosage is just wrong. Did you check?
I appreciate your enthusiasm, my friend, but I checked the dosage. It was the first thing I...
Of course you did. I'm so dumb. Sorry. So maybe there's something wrong with the delivery system?
Again, I also checked that. Listen, I appreciate your interest in my work, but it's a little hard to focus with all these questions.
Not a problem. I'll just observe. It's really something else watching you work. Always wanted to get into interrogation.
Is that so?
Absolutely. Not the violent kind. Beating people up, electricity and breaking bones. It isn't my deal at all. No, more like the subtle stuff, indirect stuff that you do.
I understand. Do you want to know what the secret is?
Absolutely.
Keeping quiet. Let the subject talk.
Oh, got it.
So I've started practicing breathing under. So if we had someone we had to pacify, would you shoot him in the legs, or maybe go for the shoulder? To me, I'd go for the soft parts of his thigh, or maybe try to graze him just on the neck. You know, a nice like flesh wound. I think that'd stop him.
What are you rambling about? Is this your nonstop stream of consciousness? You're just letting go? Saying whatever you feel like when your disturbed brain tells you to?
You know, I ought to put a few rounds in you, friend. Maybe you'd stop being such a dick. Yeah, you suck.
Don't take it personal. You're freaking out, okay? I'm sorry. I didn't know it was such a big deal for you. I'm sorry! Jesus Christ! Just get back to work, okay? Wow.
I'm sorry, Mr. Burke, but we're not done yet, so it might turn up, you know? I'll keep you posted.
Hmm.
Sir.
If my old man had been alive, he'd run those dicks out in the street with a shotgun.
Yeah, I know what you mean, yeah. I mean, if it was my family house, I wouldn't be happy either.
Pops was a hard man, you know? I mean, he really told it like it was. He'd always say, ain't no problem the Bible and a shotgun can't solve. That's just the way he was, you know? How these people treat his house. It's messed up, man.
Weapons just lying around. Go deal with it.
Okay, stay put. I'll take a look.
Absolutely.
You are 5x5, Echo Foxtrot. Come in. Someone has been a real pain in the ass.
Big Cat. I've arrived at the location, and it looks clear. Over.
You've got a weapon just lying around over there. Stand back. I'll investigate. I hear you.
Over. Acknowledged.
Stand back, please. I will investigate.
Hey, check up on the nitroglycerin. We need to make sure we got more than enough.
We got plenty.
Okay, good. And we are done. But let's just double check.
Hi there, Grunt.
The guy Ezra Berg has tied up in the interrogation room. He's one of the enemy's couriers.
They call themselves Admirals, posh bastards. The enemy uses them to communicate with their in-world operatives, just so there's no direct contact.
The boss got one of them in Johannesburg, didn't he? Shot him dead in an underground car park. So why keep this one alive?
The interrogator, Ezra Berg, has a way with people. He's got more drugs than God out there in his makeshift lab. I'm willing to bet the dapper little shit knows more than he's leading on. Berg will make him talk.
Harold. You could bet it's gonna ring to him.
Come on, give me a break.
Oh,
That is Sean Rose, terrorist turned insurgent.
Just look at it. Lagging. So sloppy. Disconcerting. Oh, why the hell doesn't anyone else care about this?
Ridiculous outfit.
Pure, white, pristine, unstained, unsoiled, untainted, unsullied.
What a beautiful clock. perfect time, too. I bet Rose tinkers with it every chance he gets. He's almost obsessed with this thing.
What a shock.
Maybe it was just a poltergeist. I ain't afraid of no ghost.
Very clever, 47. This ought to rattle this cage.
Sir.
Tainted.
Hey, soldier, what the hell do you think you're doing?
Oh, yeah, no. My shift's over. Cut something out.
Very clever, 47. This ought to rattle his cage.
Sadist. A lot of them. It hurts just to look at it. One, two, three. What is happening? This is bad. I'm covered. I'm covered, you know. Oh God, they're everywhere. Oh, get them off.
Beautiful clock.
Keeps perfect time, too. I bet Rose tinkers with it again. He's almost obsessed with this thing.
Hey!
Oh!
Coyote,
how copy over. Need medevac in grid.
grid 90746. Over. Hey, are you okay?
Big Papa, this is Ghost Rider. Send Drifter up to look at some disturbances in my sector. Over.
Come in, come in. Yeah, it's a goddamn massacre. You sending someone down?
Why are these weapons okay. just lying
around?
I
could use a hand here. It's one big clusterfuck.
Wait here. If you hear gunshots, run like crazy.
Affirmative.
gotta be.
You're accountable for the...
Jesus Christ! Hey, let go, man! Stop. You'll strangle someone like that! Somebody help!
Yes, that's it. That does look good.
Straight lines, perfect pattern.
Looks good.
Command, looks like the garden is all clear. Over.
Secure the perimeter.
What's going on? Come on, sit.
Corridor is clear.
Hey, calm down. What is wrong?
What a beautiful clock. It's perfect time, too. I bet Rose tinkers with it every chance he gets. He's almost obsessed with this thing.
Once they hook into shape for Moore's fiber optic cable lines, we can hack their closed circuit network and release Herbert. That's what we, the team, called the virus.
So Herbert destroys their R&D, stocks plummet, investors cut and run, and Schaefer Moore goes to the garbage dump of history.
See, you don't always have to spill blood to make an impact.
Thank you, Finn. That's truly profound. Eyes on the ball, people. This ain't a drill.
security breach. Stay with me.
I got it.
Echo Foxtrot to November Zulu. Over. I think someone is firing a gun. How are we doing?
Okay.
Roger.
This is Rogue One. Actual garden area is clear.
Graves is down. Excellent work, 47.
Need some security and paramedics here. I don't know. It's a mess. It looks like some kind of accident, but I don't know yet.
Well, no one said this fight came without a high price.
What?
Copy that command.
Okay.
Setting perimeter, and I'll start to clean this bloody mess. Over.
That's not bloody working. How are
you? What's the status on the ammo?
We're all good.
Good. That reminds me, I need to check with Rose if we need anything special for Mexico.
Got it.
Okay, enough talk. On your hands and feet and give me 100.
Thank you.
amount of freaks being brought into this camp has increased recently. Rose is on his own planet. But that new interrogation guy with the mask, what, Berg was it? What the hell's going on?
You know what? I talked to him earlier over a smoke. He's a really nice guy. Really eloquent, soft-spoken.
Used to work with Mossad as a chemical interrogation expert.
Yeah, and super creepy, more like it. Why the mask? Guards? Almost blew his head off the first time I ran into him. Came out of that lab, you know. That man. Gonna come face to face with a backwater murderous cannibal type.
I guess it means the mask is working. Anyway, I'm happy he's on our side. What I should be strapped to a chair, drugged to hell, and having to look at that mask.
And he's off again.
Wonder what he's so busy with.
Time for another cigarette, I guess.
Unconscious. Why, Ezra, that's very embarrassing. That makes no sense at all. I'll need to check my numbers.
Thank you.
You don't want to be too close to me.
Okay, my friend. Get those eyes open again. No sleeping on the job. Yes, that's it. Come back to us now. Excellent. So,
yes. Hold up a second, Private. Hold it right there.
So, young friend, let's try again.
Wasting your time. We heralds are only messengers. Nothing to offer that you don't already know.
You say? Well, what about your superior? The leader of the heralds? The one you call Constant? Surely he knows. Such is the identity of the Parliaments.
It's possible that I never asked. Like a bookkeeper. Like the guy you sit next to on the bus, plain as vanilla. That's the idea. You'll never find him.
Warmonger.
He'll find you. Give me another dose, Doctor. Break my mind. Won't do you any good.
Oh, a little bit of high voltage never did anyone any harm. Click it, flip it, press it, turn it, twist it, and you're on.
out by shipment. These are highly potent solutions. This is not, dare I say, recreation. If you see anyone who wants it, please let me know. I need it for the interrogation. Besides, in the wrong dosage, crap, this will kill you.
Formations, let's move. Weapons hot.
Oh.
Huh?
This is an easy fix. I'm the man. Girls love a fixer. There it is. And on.
Oh.
I've got you six. Ezra Berg has been eliminated. Good work, 47.
Someone is setting off explosions.
Copy that.
Command, you copy? I'm at the location now, and I have nothing to report. Over. Affirmative. Moving on. Out.
Okay?
Oh, shit, you're not okay.
Command, we need some help here to clean this mess up.
This is not good, my friend. Not good. Bravo, shoot his
head! Cut that off!
Yeah, what's going on?
He's at the shooting range!
take on the Spark.
Rose? Oh, nasty little prick, if you ask me. Sure, it's not his fault that he grew up in that crazy collective farm out in the outback. What were they called? Sons of Solidarity? No, they're a bunch of left-wing cultists. But still, some of that stuff he's done makes my skin crawl. The oil rig, I get it. Man, kids died.
Boss seems to trust him.
Yeah, of course he does. Rose is the perfect acolyte.
Finn,
he's smart.
It's Rose.
He's ruthless.
Doing my rounds and coming over your way. Tell the geeks to get ready for inspection.
No, I've met his kind before. Rose yearns for a cause, sure, but any cause will do. Because deep down, the only thing he's really looking for is justification to blow people up. Don't get me wrong. Sean Rose was born for this. The enemy doesn't expect it. Their cruelty, it's too remote. You know, you sign a document, thousands of people die half a world away. It's unreal, like drone operators. But Rose and the boss, the enemy doesn't know how to react. The savagery. That's how.
All right, let's go again. On your marks. Ready, set, execute.
Like bring an axe to a chest.
That's it. Let loose on that hip.
Engage!
Go for a headshot. You!
moving on to Delta Zulu. Over. What? Did you see something? We've got ourselves a serious... Any description or possible suspect?
I didn't see the bastard.
C2, I have arrived at location and it looks clear. Over.
All right, let's go again. On your mark. Ready, set, execute.
Maya Parvati is down. Good work.
It's been an accident. Don't know, Command. I don't know that either, Command. I just got...
keep your distance, sir.
Please stay back. Hey, nice shot. Bet you can't do that again.
Oh, you got a big mouth, that's for sure.
Hey, Marco, you mind?
I'm not sure I've seen you.
Who are you? Whoa!
Hey, mister, don't turn your back on me.
Copy. I've got a body.
Do me a favor and get rid of that thing, would you? I hate guns.
Nice one. Yeah, let me see you do it again.
Can't wait, pretty boy.
Greetings, sir.
I guess they're pimping them out for a good reason, but they're not very informative. You sometimes feel like there's an A team and a B team. Know what I mean?
Yeah.
Yeah, what I mean is if the guy next to you is not on the same page, it can cost you a few seconds.
You better pick that weapon up over there, buddy.
It's me. I can't really explain, but could you send someone down? We need to do a quick check. Over.
No trespassing beyond this point, sir. This is your...
Mike 1, Tango is standing down. Thank you, sir. Stay clear now.
There's a goddamn weapon over there. What the fuck?
This is Charlie at 94 November. Someone to come down here and investigate the disturbance.
Fascinating. According to the blueprint, Sean...
Good to see you.
I feel filthy again. I hope I brought
excellent
another person.
I dare say Rose is about to get a taste of his own medicine.
Rose ought to make the gel himself easy.
Hey, buddy. You know it. Yep. You know I can't let you through. Sorry, brother.
Email. Boom?
Sean Rose confirmed down. Nicely done, 47.
Affirmative.
Something's going down. Courtyard's peaceful. All clear, sir. Anything from anybody else. Over. Clear.
Command, reporting a possible situation. At first glance, it could be an accident. Securing crime scene and establishing perimeter.
Hey, you, what is this? You did this?
Command.
Rand, I'm here now and the area is clear. Over.
Ah, strange.
Whoa!
Me again. We've got another accident on our hands. Is it just me, or haven't we seen a lot of these lately? No, it looks legit.
Discard the bat. Understand? It's time to drop the bat. I don't see anything in the workshop. Moving on.
Heads up. We have a situation. What in the hell?
Everything will be fine.
Yeah, whatever.
That's it. Going to the Mile High Stadium.
Hey there, bro. No trespassing here. That's right, I'm out of your league.
I don't want to see you here again.
Ah, strange.
Affirmative.
The plot thickens.
Someone left in a hurry.
Sean Rose was not the Shadow Client. That much is clear. Whoever commands the militia, they got out just in time. Look around, 47. We're getting closer.
Someone's done their homework.
Look how far it dates back. Hayamoto, Beldingford, Delvade. The Shadow Client has been tracking you for decades.
Now how is that possible?
It isn't. Every one of those missions were branded as unsolved or accidents. He must have been looking for a pattern, a certain M.O., which would mean...
He knows me.
Well, at least this shortens the list.
Some kind of network. Power players. From all sectors.
Familiar faces, too. Thomas Cross. Klaus Strandberg. Ether. And that's missing banker Eugene Cobb. Well, well.
There's a name. Providence.
What? No. No, it can't be.
The Hidden Hand. Thought they were a myth.
A hypothesis, nothing more. The idea that a small cabal of kingmakers, controlling enough corporate and political leaders, could effectively run the world in secret.
Maybe not so hypothetical.
Keep looking, 47. We need full disclosure.
Found something.
Sodas. But that would mean Providence has infiltrated ICA, and Eric Sodas is their operative. Bastard! It all fits. He was the one who persuaded the rest of the ICA board to greenlight this operation. This changes everything. Get out, 47. We got what we came for.
What about the Shadow Clan?
He is no longer our primary concern. ICA has been compromised. I always wondered if Providence was real, but I never actually... I will need to confer with the board, but mark my words, 47. This will have consequences.
Rose is gone.
It was me, wasn't it? They tracked me. I don't believe it. I took every precaution.
Rose knew the risks. They all do. You did well, Olivia. I am proud of you. Now listen. The ICA knows about you. They kept you alive because they needed you, and now they don't. We won't talk again. Not until the storm is over.
I don't like it. This man you know what he's capable of. You need to end this now.
I ran away as a boy. My friend and I. Away from that place. We came upon a small farming community. The people were dirt poor, but this woman, she took us in. We were awakened the next morning by the shots. A dozen people lay face down in the snow. Our warden didn't like to leave witnesses. They shot the woman and her family last. They made sure that we watched the whole thing. This is your gift, the warden told us. Your gift and your curse. Touching lives only by ending them.
You know him.
Better than anyone.
Good morning, 47. The board has sanctioned Eric Soder's for termination. After Colorado, we did some digging into Soder's private affairs and discovered that he has been fast-tracked for critical heart surgery at the hyper-exclusive Gama Private Hospital in Hokkaido, Japan. Such a display of power has Providence written all over it. Soder's, who suffers from a rare condition known as situs inversus, where his internal organs are reversed, desperately needs a right-sided heart transplant and has clearly betrayed the ICA to get it. He was admitted last night and is currently being prepped for a 3-day surgery. We have booked you into Gama under the usual guise of Tobias Reaper, corporate shark, here for a standard medical checkup. As such, you will need to play it by ear and procure whatever tools you need to complete the mission. You also need to eliminate Yuki Yamazaki, a Tokyo lawyer who works for Providence. Sodas has already given Yamazaki access to our client records and has agreed to provide a full list of active ICA operatives post-operation. This transaction cannot be allowed to happen. Sodas must pay for his treachery, and his insidious employers must be taught a lesson. ICA's sovereignty is at stake. Powerful as Providence may be, we need to draw a line in the sand. I will leave you to prepare. Welcome to Hokkaido, 47. The Gama Private Hospital provides cutting-edge medical treatment for the global elite, outside the law, if required. The facility is partially run by an artificial intelligence system known as Kai. The AI oversees patient admission to various areas in the hospital, and even participates in some medical procedures. You will find Eric Soders in the operating theater, undergoing a pre-surgery regenerative stem cell treatment, a highly controversial procedure yet to be approved by Japanese authorities. Yuki Yamazaki has already arrived. You'll find her in her suite or roaming the restaurant and spa areas of the hospital. Soders is scheduled to be put under soon. Let us make sure he stays that way. Good luck, 47.
Hello, Mr. Reaper. As part of the service here at Gamma, your personal robe has been outfitted with a radio frequency identification chip. The device will unlock and allow access to your personal suite.
Client long? Couple of months. Yeah, it's a good situation. Miss Yamazaki's very smart, very capable. Tough as nails, too. You should see her in the courtroom.
She seems a bit, I don't know, untimely? Like she's not comfortable in her own skin?
Yeah, you saw how she dropped her fags off the lift crossing the gorge. It's just nicotine cravings.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, that was me 5 years ago. Glad I got that monkey off my back. Hey! We should get her a pack, make a good impression.
In a place like this, good luck.
So the client's a truck.
Yuki Yamazaki dropped her cigarettes off the lift when arriving at the hospital. According to her bodyguards, this has put her on edge. Maybe you can help quench those cravings, 47. Cigarettes are contraband at Gamma, but surely not everyone follows the rules.
A lawyer?
Criminal defense. Yamazaki takes all the controversial cases. Yakuza,
in particular. She's virtually their in-house attorney. Word has it there are blood ties, that her father was, you know, Yakuza. Rumors.
I know I'm new and all, but it's pretty clear to me that whoever Yuki Yamazaki works for, it ain't the friggin' Yakuza. You think a bunch of common criminals have the influence to clear a waiting list at the world's most elite hospital?
There are certain things we don't talk about. That, right there, is one of them.
You're enjoying your stay.
47, I have intel about that bandaged patient. Well, this is quite fascinating. The bandaged patient is Jason Portman, former CEO of Quantum Leap. According to my intel, he has undergone full facial reconstruction and is scheduled for bandage removal today. And get this, he's going for the full Helmut Kruger look.
Daily checkups, they said.
Yeah, right.
Better call my name soon or I'll buy the whole place and fire everyone. Have them killed.
Oh, Director. Can I just say how much I've enjoyed my stay here? The spa facilities are just fantastic.
You look radiant.
Shut up, Helm. Wait, you're not Helmut.
What is it with you?
Oh, mate, that's not a body, is it? Oh, no! Help me, you gotta...
You're not Helmut.
Mr. Jason Portman, please come to the hospital entrance. A doctor will escort you to your checkup. That was for Mr. Jason Portman. A doctor will escort you to your appointment.
That is Yuki Yamazaki, former lawyer to the Yakuza and current operative for Providence.
Ah, Mr. Portman. Perfect timing. Follow me to the consultation room, if you please. You must be eager to see...
Please, just go away.
Greetings, sir.
Gentlemen, Mr. Portman is with me. No need to bother him with unnecessary security measures. You're in good hands, Mr. Portman.
Hello there.
Such an incredible place. I hope you're holding up all right. I read the latest test results that Kai published on the internal network. You're in good shape, Mr. Portman. Might want to cut back on the sake, but otherwise you're doing well. Should be able to go back home real soon. We've got a new yoga instructor here, JB. Boy, he can stretch like a rubber band. Never seen anything quite like it. If you're feeling sore and the meds aren't doing it for you, you should really go see him. So, facial surgery? Tends to heal pretty quickly. But I understand yours was quite extensive. Don't worry, though. We've got the best facilities here. You'll get those bandages off in no time at all. Okay, Mr. Portman, your surgeon is in here. He should be ready for your checkup. Have a nice day.
Smart way to get inside, 47. Well done.
Mr. Portman, thank you for waiting. If you can just sit down for a moment, I'll get started right away. So, let's have a look at you, Mr. Portman. I'll be still as I remove the bandages. Oh. Oh my. It's astonishing. Not only are you the spitting image of Helmut Krueger, the swelling has completely subsided and there's not a trace of bruising. If I didn't know any better, I'd say you'd never undergone surgery. It's perfect. It's simply perfect. I'm sorry. This is very emotional for me.
Those aren't push-ups. Steve Gaynor knows how to do a push-up.
Sometimes he walks around in like a fancy suit, sometimes just a bathing suit, and we're cool with it. Because that's Steve Gaynor. Steve Gaynor cool.
See how I do this?
Identify yourself. Okay, this guy's unreal. Is he a buddy of yours? Sir, I'm talking to you. Hold it right there. Got a snake hiding.
He went in there.
Holy shit, you hear?
Target took one.
Mr. Portman, thank you for waiting. If you can just sit down for a moment, I'll get started right away.
You are pathetic. You call those push-ups? Looks more like yoga. The last guy, he knew how to do a push-up.
Oh, man. That was good. That was really good.
So, let's have a look at you, Mr. Portman. Now be still as I remove the bandages. Oh my. It's astonishing. Not only are you the spitting image of Helmut Krueger, the swelling has completely subsided and there's not a trace of bruising. If I didn't know any better, I'd say you'd never undergone surgery. It's perfect. Simply perfect. I'm sorry. This is very emotional for me.